the period we have seen the format of balance sheet. Okay, then we studied the liability side item and the asset side item. Okay, so you look at the so equity and liability. So this is the format current year particulars.
One minute.
Yes. So equity and liabilities. Under equity and liabilities, four major heads: shareholders fund, share application money, pending allotment, non-current liabilities, and current liabilities. Then under shareholders fund, share capital, reserve and surplus, money received against share warrant, mainly share capital, reserve and surplus. Then non-current liabilities mean long-term borrowings only mean. Then current liabilities, short-term borrowing, bank overdraft, sometimes trade payable, other current liabilities and short-term provision. So everything it is important. Okay. So shareholders fund, share capital, reserve and surplus. So one thing you have to remember, today I will complete this chapter. Then I think Friday I can conduct a test. Okay. Class test Friday. So today I will send the MCQ. Okay, it is very easy. Only one thing you have to remember. So I am planning 10 mark. Listen, 10 mark MCQ. Then 20 major head and sub head. 28, half mark each. Clear? Any doubts? Any doubt? So 10 MCQ question. Then 20, you have to write major head and sub head. Items I will give. So on that basis, major head and sub head you have to write. Okay, pattern same, 20 mark. Okay, any doubts? Okay, so simple only. Shareholders fund, suppose if you have any doubt, then we will clear, then only I will take the test. So equity and liabilities, under that shareholders fund, share application money, pending allotment, if no item is there, then also you have to write share application money, pending allotment, non-current liabilities, under that main long-term borrowing, current liabilities, short-term borrowing, trade payable, other current liabilities, short-term provision. Then asset side, non-current assets and major head, non-current assets and current assets. So under that non-current assets, fixed assets. Under fixed assets, tangible assets, intangible assets, capital work in progress, intangible assets under development. These are the subhead is fixed assets. Next, major head is non-current assets. Next, another item, non-current investment, that is very important. Other non-current assets, anything I said, other non-current assets. Other long-term trade receivable. Suppose normally discount on issue of share or debenture and the preliminary expenses, we are treating as under non-current assets, fictitious assets. Okay, but here what we said, reserve and surplus minus item. Is it correct? Reserve and surplus minus item. So from securities premium we have to deduct. If a security premium is not there, then from profit we have to deduct. Suppose if a reserve is not there in the question, then also minus we can write. That only is three. So next, current assets, current investments, inventory, trade receivable, cash and cash equivalents, other current assets. Okay, current investments, important, inventory, trade receivable, cash and cash equivalents, short-term loans and advances, other current assets. Okay, so already we studied what are the items are included in each item. So I send a question. So from that, the second one we will do now. So you look at that. First, you have to prepare a format of balance sheet. Normally, they are not asking this one, format of balance sheet. Only they are asking. Major head and subhead. Okay. So whenever we prepare the balance sheet, only one column is enough. Current year. Okay. Balance sheet of Amba Limited. As on 31st March 2020. So you have to look, first you have to look what are the items are given in the particulars. Debenture, equity share capital, securities premium, preliminary expenses, statement of profit and loss account, discount on issue of debenture, loose tools, bank balance, cash in hand. Okay, that it is given. So share capital, so question you have to look for equity share capital it is given, then securities premium reserve, so there we have can adjust more items, securities premium reserve is there, preliminary expenses, discount on issue of shares, statement of profit and loss account. Okay, then long term discount on 8% debenture. Okay, so what do you have to do first? You have to prepare notes to accounts. First you have to prepare notes to account, then we will prepare the balance sheet. First normally balance sheet, then notes to account. So after preparing notes to account only we can do that. Notes to account is compulsory. Particular is amount. Now, so notes to account. So after preparing balance sheet, now we will prepare, first we will prepare notes to account, then we will prepare a balance sheet. Because notes to account, final amount only, it will come in the balance sheet. So first one, we know that equity and liability. Under equity and liability, first one, shareholders fund. Under shareholders fund, first subhead, which one? Share capital. Share capital. So it is directly given. So no need to prepare which one, first notes to account. If you prepare also, no problem. Okay, one, share capital. Under that, equity share capital. Okay, so if you want, you will write. equity share capital 60 lakh. Okay, this is first working note. Next one, reserve and surplus. So we know that reserve and surplus, what are the items are included? Old reserve, securities premium. Okay, old reserve, securities premium, profit and loss account, statement of profit and loss account. Here, debit balance. So whether it is profit or loss, anyone? Debit balance, profit and loss account.
Loss.
Yes, loss. So, it is a credit balance. Okay, profit only. Okay, this credit balance, if it is debit balance loss, this is credit balance only. Okay, so it is profit. So here, preliminary expenses, discount on issue of shares, it is there. So already I said what we are doing. So we have to write off from securities premium. If securities premium is not there, then we will take from profit and loss account. So you look at this question, how much preliminary expenses and a discount on issue of shares? First, preliminary expenses, how much amount? 40,000. Preliminary expenses, 40,000. Okay. Then you look at how much security. First, we have to write off from securities premium. Securities premium, how much amount? 20,000. Is that correct? Securities premium 20,000. Preliminary expenses 40,000. Then next, discount on issue of debenture, that is 40,000. So how we will write? So first you have to write securities premium. Preliminary expenses. So we will get minus 20,000. Then that is over. Next one, statement of profit and loss account. So statement of profit and loss account, we have 1,50,000. If you make it to 1,50,000. So from that we have to write off discount on issue of debenture. Discount on issue of debenture.
Ninety thousand.
Okay, first you have to take securities premium. So then statement of profit loss account. This is reserve and surplus. Now, then there is a shareholders fund, share capital, reserve and surplus. Next major had a non-current liability. In that, here in this question, debenture it is given. Debenture. That is come under long-term borrowings. So in that 8% debenture, you know that long term borrowing. From this question, only debenture 10 lakh. Next, sir. No other item under long term borrowing. So debenture, equity share capital, securities premium, prelim expenses, statement of profit and loss, discount ratio, debenture. Next, loose tools, balance, cash in hand. So loose tools. Where it will come? Anyone know loose tools? Which head? Subhead? Loose tools.
Inventories.
Yes. So, inventories. Loose tools, next sir, balance, bank balance, cash in hand, subhead, anyone? Cash and cash equivalents. Okay, so notes to account is over. So now you have to remember, you have to study subhead and each item comes under subhead. Okay, so this is the notes to account working note. Now we will prepare balance sheet.
format. Okay, first equity and liabilities. That first one, shareholders fund. We know that shareholders fund consists of share capital, then reserve and surplus. Share capital, then reserve and surplus. So share note to notes number means working note number. First, if you are not writing, no need to write. So we wrote that share capital, so note number one. Reserve and surplus, note number two. So we did working note, that amount you have to write. So share capital, how much amount we wrote? 50 lakh. Reserve and surplus, we wrote 90,000. 90,000. So here money received against share warranty is not there. So one thing already I said, share application money, pending allot money. If no item it is there, then also you write. Then non-current liabilities, here only one item, that is long-term borrowing. So we did work note, debenture 10 lakh. That is working note three. Next, you have to look at current liability. Here, no current liabilities. Is it correct? No current liabilities. Okay, over. So here, so they didn't mention all the items, so that's why it will not be equal. So some items only it is given, otherwise it will be both said it will be equal. Next, assets. But the non-current asset, it is not given, so no need to be. We are not writing also, no problem. Okay.
So if it is not given, so if it is not writing also, no problem. But the share application money pending allotment, you have to write.
So on the base of items given in the question.
Statement, right?
Working note for 20,000. So in this question, no need to write. If you no need to write total, okay. But example, if all item it is given, if a non-current assets, if it is given means both side, it will be equal. Now, next question. So, next question you have to look from the given purchase of Shine and Bright Company Limited as at 31st March 2020, prepare a balance sheet in accordance with the Schedule 3 of the Companies Act 2013. So what are the item it is given? Preliminary expenses, discount on issue of debenture, 10% debenture, stock in trade, cash at bank, bills receivable, goodwill, loose tools, motor vehicle, provision for tax, balance in statement of profit and loss account. Okay, here share the capital not given. So this is complete. Okay, so you look at that here. Preliminary expenses, discount on issue of debenture. First, you have to look any securities premium. Any securities premium? No. So, but statement of profit and loss account it is given. Statement of profit and loss account it is given. So, how to write off a preliminary expense and discount on issue of debenture from statement of profit and loss account? Okay, so we will do the working note here. No share capital. Okay, so here security premium is not there, but a statement of profit given. So you have to write off preliminary expenses and discount on issue debenture from statement of profit and loss account. From profit and loss account. Depends. Next, debenture, long-term borrowings, 10% debenture. Long-term borrowing, 10% debenture. Then liability side item, stock in trade, current assets, cash and current assets, goodwill assets, fixed assets, current assets, motor vehicles, provision for tax. Provision for tax. Provision for tax is what? Short-term provision or long-term provision?
Short-term.
Very good. Very good.
Sir, can you show the previous slide? Okay, sir.
So liability is over. If you look the question, you can understand. Early expenses, discount on issue of debenture, debenture, then stock in trade, cash at bank, bills receivable, goodwill. Loose tools, motor vehicle, provision for tax, liability, statement of profit is going over. Now, fixed assets, tangible. Here, motor vehicle is there. Motor vehicle. So only motor vehicle, goodwill, intangible assets only. Okay. Stock in trade, inventory, cash at bank, cash in, cash equivalents, bills receivable, trade receivable. So okay, fixed assets intangible. Now, current assets inventories. Inventories in this question, stock in trade is given. No, loose tool also given. So inventories, stock in trade, loose tools. Next, bills receivable that come under trade receivable. Next head, trade receivable. Okay, trade receivable, bills receivable, cash and cash equivalents, cash at bank. Okay, so now you can prepare the format of balance sheet. So next period, I will do the balance sheet. Okay. So next period,